In this video, we are going to learn the basic Java syntax. So a basic Java program will consist of a package, class, method, and a code statement. I'll show you an example. This is an example of a basic Java program. In this, the first line is the package. Third line is the class. Fourth line is the method. And the sixth line is our code statement. I will tell you one by one. Okay. First of all, let us take package. What is a package? Suppose think that I'm going to this PC. Inside this PC, there are different individual folders. So PC will act as a package. Inside that package, there will be different folders. So in Java, inside a package, there will be different classes, methods, interface, all those kind of things will be there. The package is just like a folder. Inside that, there will be classes, method, interface. Now, how to write the name of a package? Suppose I'm going to develop a music app for Ghana.com, or the website Ghana. I'm going to develop a music app. So the website of Ghana is Ghana.com. So how to write the package name? I need to write this in the reverse order. Such that it is com.ghana. Suppose I'm going to work for Flipkart, flipkart.com. Then how to write the package name in the reverse order? That is com.flipkart. Now you need to tell me. Suppose I'm going to work for Amazon, amazon.com. Then how I want to write the package name in the reverse order? That is com.amazon. Suppose I am going to start a company, shindon.com. Then how to write the package name in the reverse order? So package is over. And the naming convention, you can use uppercase letter or lowercase letter. There is no problem. A good practice is to use lowercase letter. Now, this is the demo program that we discussed. Here the package name, it is com.smartengineer. Now class. Remember this thing. A class name should always start with an uppercase letter. So let us discuss some class names. This is the class name, main. Is there any problem? Yes, this class name is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because class name should always start with an uppercase letter. See, here it is correct. Why it is correct? Because class name is starting with an uppercase letter. Now the second word. See, in this class name, what is the problem? Class name is starting with an uppercase letter, but still it is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because the second word, see, second word should also start with capital letter. So class name should always start with a capital letter, and the next word coming after that should be also in capital letter. Now, what is the problem? Here it is small letter. So this class name is wrong. The right format is, it should start with a capital letter, and the next word should also start with uppercase letter. Now, here it is starting with uppercase letter, but the remaining words are in small letter. So the right format, it will be like this. A class name should always start with an uppercase letter, and the remaining words should also start with uppercase letter. Now, in our program, the name of class is main, and it is starting with an uppercase letter. Now, we can discuss method. In method, the name should start with a lowercase letter. In class, the name should start with uppercase letter. In method, name should start with lowercase letter. Let's discuss now some method names. See here, is it right? No, it is not right. It is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because method name should start with lowercase letter. So this is the right format. Now, here, again, method is starting with capital letter. So it is wrong. Method should always start with small letter. Now here it is starting with small letter, and the next word should be in capital letter. It is same like class. In method, the first letter should be in small letter, but the remaining words should start with capital letter or uppercase letter. Now here, method is starting with lowercase letter, but the next word is also in small letter. So that is wrong. Next word should start with capital letter. So a method should start with a lowercase letter, and then the next word should start with uppercase letter. Now here it is already wrong because method could not start with uppercase letter. So this is wrong. The correct format is like this. Method should always start with the lowercase letter, and the remaining words are in uppercase letter. So a class name should start with an uppercase letter. A method name should start with a lowercase letter. The remaining words should be in uppercase letter. So far, so good. Now, this is the program. In our program, the method name, it is main, and it is starting with a lowercase letter. This was our program, the basic Java program. In this, we learned what is package, what is a class, how class name is starting, but we don't know what is this public, static, void, all those kind of things. Okay. First of all, I will tell you what is public. Public is an access modifier. Some other access modifiers are private, default, protected. So as you know, public transport, what it means, everyone can access it. Like that, if we are making our main method as public, then we can access it from anywhere. Now, static. What do you mean by static? If you are making our main method as static, then we does not need to create object to call our main method. So you will have a doubt how to create object, which we will discuss in the later video. Now just listen. We does not need to create object if you are making our method as static. Okay. Now void. Void means we does not require any return type for our method. If instead of void, if we are going to use integer, then we require the return type, a number. If you are going to, instead of void, if you are going to make our main method as boolean, if you are going to write here as public static boolean main, then what should be the return type? It should be either true or false. But if you are making our main method as void, then we does not require any return type. Now, after main method, there is a bracket. Inside the bracket, it is written as string, then a square bracket, args. What do we mean by that? Here, this step is an array, initializing an array. So you need to know how to initialize an array. String, then square bracket, which means it is an array of string, args. It is the name of that array. Args is a short form of arguments. So in this step, it is string, it is an array of string, then the name of that string is args. Now we can see at the end, there is a parenthesis. So inside that parenthesis, we are going to write our code statements for the code. Now let's open IntelliJ, and we can open a new project. File, new project, then Java, next. Then I'm going to put tick mark here. Then click next. I'm going to name the project name as demo. I'm going to show you a demo. Finish. In this window, I'm going to open. See, by default, we are getting our basic Java syntax. That is package, class, then our main method. Now here, we need to write our code. So here I'm going to write a simple program, that is how to print hello world. For that, the system need to print hello world. So I need to write system. So start with capital S. If you are starting with small letter S, you will not get the suggestion system. If you write with capital S, you will get the suggestion system in the second line. Press enter, dot, out, because the system need to display it. Dot, then the method print line. Now inside the bracket, we are going to write the hello world. For that, you need to put double inverted comma. Hello world. Now always make sure that at the end of each code statement, you need to put semicolon. Now let's run this program. And we can see whether we are getting our output. Our output is hello world. Now I'm going to make a small change here. Let's make it as subscribe. And if you remove this print line ln, there is no problem. With print also, we can display the output. If you are going to put print here, then this gap will not be there. After hello world, there will not be gap. You can check. See, we are going to get the output as subscribe. And